guys, welcome to today's episode of Being African. I'm Muna and
I'm Jeumie, and today I'm so excited to introduce to you our first topic on our series Dating in Nigeria. Today we are talking about the tips and tricks that you need to ace that first date.
Yes.
It's a first date and you're supposed to meet somebody to decide if he likes you and if you like him and if you want to, you know, have,
get something,
you know, get something
more from it,
you know, and then you decide to take somebody along. What if he ends up liking her more? You know, it reminds me of what happened to me in the university.
Oh, yeah,
a friend of mine had a date and she didn't want to go alone, so she told me to follow. Please follow that. Unfortunately, the guy, you know, liked me more. I didn't even know that till after the date, and my friend was telling me that.
Wow.
So that she had gone, you know.
You see, so ladies, please, when you have date, just try going alone. At least the first date, go alone. It's advisable
to
know,
go alone. It's about you getting to know somebody. Why would you want him to get to know you and get to know
with
another person?
Else,
you know,
there could be these mixed feelings.
You know,
so just be on the safe side and just go alone.
And then you know the financial aspect.
You
are not supposed to go on the first date with somebody. We should assume that when you're going to on the first date with somebody, you already trust him to a certain extent to go meet him in a public place.
Yeah.
So you don't need a guardian ninja.
This is for the guys. Guys, please, when making them choices of where you want your date to be, please try consider how much you're willing to spend. If you have this idea of how much you want to spend on a date, stick to it. Go to places you can afford. Don't take that to places you can't afford. I'm saying this because I've had experiences, though. But I'm just like trying to generalize it. Please, guys, just always do that, because in most cases, you just don't know. You might just meet a lady who would actually want to really, you know, other things you can afford, and then you start speaking Spanish and
You want to get to know the person really well.
Yeah.
I should assume that you go on a lunch date or a dinner date. You know, then you get to talk in a
quiet
place.
Yourself.
You know, get to know the person. But if you just want to hang out, then you can go to the cinemas, or you know, you can go like maybe watch a match or something. I wouldn't expect to get a
match
to
like
know
you
me.
Really want to know me on the first date, and you're taking me for a food. Are you serious? A football match?
We'll
get to talk. That's the thing. So if you need time to talk, or you need to probably establish a relationship with your date, then you should take note of places you take your date to. Don't go to rowdy places or noisy places. You don't get to communicate then.
Talking to the ladies, because I know that ladies are slick queens. When we're going on dates, we always try to look good. But guys, please, we all know that you always want to be real. Like, you don't want to form in quotes. But pay attention to your dressing. You know, why are you going on dates and your shoe is dirty? Like, endeavor to clean your shoes, please. You know, bed gang on go. Please brush it.
Just called.
Please. Then please brush your hair. Look good.
Clean your shoes. Smell nice. The way you expect ladies to look, decent or fleek, you guys should look that way too.
You know, and ladies, in as much as we want to look good, I think we shouldn't wear overly explosive things and then complain that the guy is looking at other parts.
Yeah,
or
just
anatomy.
I'll just say this just once: dress the way you want to be addressed. Yeah, that's
Sister Muna said so. But
just,
anyway,
just the way you want to be addressed, because trust me, you don't want a guy to have this bad notion about you with the way you're dressed. You're dressed that way.
Don't mind that. But guys who have bad notions or any notion, whatever, whatsoever, you know, it doesn't matter what you wear. You wear a hijab and all that. You don't have bad notion. You have bad notion. But mine is, first be comfortable in what you wear.
Yeah,
and look good. Look, guys and girls, please look good. Use your roll-ons and your deodorants and your, you know, perfumes, and dress very
nice.
You don't have to go over the top, but just be very, very presentable, guys and girls.
Never allow her pain. Really. I don't know why guys always do that. Like, on the first day, you expect the lady to pay, or even give her the room to pay. Like, it'd be like, some guys come up with crappy stories like, oh, they've never tried it. It has never happened to me. But I've heard of stories where guys come up with this lame line and they're like, well, yes, I left my wallet at home, I don't have my ATM here, I don't have much cash with me, or my bank is having one. Please come up with that line. Try and be a man and pay for your bills. If you call or if you could ask the lady to come out to hang out with you or to, on a date or whatever, you should be able to pay. Come on, don't be.
Hey. I am going to have to disagree with you on that, because first off, there is no rule that says that a guy has to pay on the first date. Although no guy should take me out and then give me that cock and bull story of forgetting you.
You
can't even tell me that because it's mobile banking, bro. But that being said, ladies, I really think that we have a sense of entitlement, and there's no big deal in subtly, you know, give a subtle offer to pay. So there is no particular rule book that says that a lady cannot pay for her own meals. We're brought up as African ladies, and the guy is supposed to, you know, provide for us and pay for us. Yes, we understand that, but there is something called vex money. Please, always hold it, you know. And now, you know,
I don't know what vex money is. Do you know what vex money is? Please tell us, Jimmy. What
you know, you have
money?
Like 2,000 naira, and then you keep it. I know that.
Okay.
Whether that rain or shine, you're spending 2,000
Yes, I know that. You should have money in your wallet just in case the guy comes up with these lines. You just pay for your bill. Just pay for just yours, and then you know you can just.
She's giving you bad advice.
Okay, or just pay for you both, but just know
you both. What? I was kidding. Don't pay for you both.
Be nice. I mean, like, oh,
a guy that tells you he forgot his ATM.
Coming for a date.
You know what's really? Supposed to use his teeth?
Come on,
please.
But I would, if I was in that situation, I'll pay for myself and then leave the guy to sort himself out.
Guys, remember that.
It's the first date. You don't want her to have bad impression about it. You don't want to give her sell yourself out cheaply. So I mean, you should act like a guy.
This is not even about selling yourself cheaply and having bad opinion about you. This is the first date. It's normal, maybe your third date, your fourth date, a girl pays or something. Yeah. But your first date, you want her to, you know, pay for your meal to show you that she's independent. No, you pay for the meal. Please do not order for the most expensive meal.
Yeah.
On the list. You know, it's not so cool. It's you know, it's cool. So bad that you don't even... Some names are so funny, yeah? They'll say... The menu, you don't even know what kind of rice it's in the Indian guinea corn, they're just, and it's so expensive. You know, it's not nice. A first date isn't about how much you can eat, it's about getting to know each other. The dates should not even necessarily be about food. You know, just don't order the most expensive meal, just order a nice meal. It's not about the food anyway, it's about him. Do not order taking meal. Please and please. It is, I don't get it. When the first date become about how much you can consume. I don't know. Like, please and please. But getting to know this guy. Oh, I like this guy. I like his personality. I like to go on a second date with him. I want to know where this, you know, he's going to lead us to. But no, it's not about, wow, babe, I went on this date with this guy. Like, ate. Oh, please. No expensive food. No takeaway.
Guys, never generalize that all ladies are the same. I mean, where do they get that notion from? Why do guys always do that? Like, you see a guy take you out on the first date, and you hear things like, oh, I thought ladies like doing this. I thought ladies like doing that. I thought you ladies are like this. You girls are like this. You these are like this. Because your ex did not treat you right, does not mean all ladies will not treat you right. Because your ex has so much love for money or material things doesn't mean you're like that. I'm just saying, if don't create that notion on the first date, or don't pass that notion to your date on the first date.
We've heard about how you shouldn't generalize. Fine, we're cool. But ladies, do not expect a guy to always initiate a conversation. But I say cliche now that you're like, the guy is so boring, but did you make effort to have a nice conversation? We don't say, hi, what's up, hello, how was your night? It's so boring. what happened to, oh, okay, so on your Facebook, you wrote something about Game of Thrones and all that. Do you love it? Oh, yeah, I love it. And then a nice conversation will follow. There's no rule to conversation. Please, girls, initiate the conversation also.
Yeah.
Initiate it. It's not only a guy's job to initiate
conversations.
And then please have meaningful conversation. You don't talk about how your nails broke and how your heels broke and how you went to a club. We do not want that. We want you to have meaningful conversations. First date is about getting to know him, him getting to know you. So please.
And first impression matters. So.
Yeah, my sister, it does.
It does.
You should be able to make a very nice impression. That when the guy thinks of you the next time, the person that comes to mind, intelligent, fun to be with.
No overtly personal questions. Don't sound like, how did you break up with your ex? Don't sound like, when last did you have sex? Don't sound like...
You know, we all know this
questions.
Just know this question. Don't ask, how much do you earn? Guys, please don't ask. We don't care.
No overtly personal questions. It's a no-no on the first date.
Please. No, how much do you earn? What is your body count?
When last did you have sex?
Please.
Throw it out.
Shouldn't expect a guy to pay for you. As in, it's a date. Understand that it's a date. Two consenting adults agree to see each other. Nobody is obliged to pay for anybody's transport. The only thing is the guy can pay for the meal, or the girl can, or they can even go Dutch. You know, they can share it, depending on whatever agreement they've had. But do not think it is your right to collect transport fare. If a guy gives me transport fare, I do not even accept it. You know, I do not. I'm not saying that if they give it to you, if a guy gives it to you, don't accept it. That's not my business. What I'm trying to say is, don't do like trans. Is please don't act like it is your right to be given a transport fare. No, it is not. If you don't have a car, you find your way back. If he gives it to you and you collect, fine, all well and good. But if he doesn't, don't make it seem like, oh, he's very stingy. He didn't give me transport fare. You guys met based on mutual agreement and you agreed to have a date.
Yeah.
It is not his job to take care of your... Thank you. To finance.
To finance your going back home. So it's not mandatory for him to pay. But if he offers to, then maybe he should.
Okay.
So guys, make sure your dates get home early and safely. This is very important. I mean, some guys have this non-challenge attitude on probably going out with a girl and then keeping up and saying, what's up, are you home? It's like, you have to remind them to do that. Oh, you know?
Yeah.
It's really advisable for you guys to actually make the effort to call your date, find out if she's home, if she's safe. And I'm emphasizing on early. Well, that's optional though. But just make sure she gets home safe and early. Check up. It's required. So guys, that being said, we've come to the end of this wonderful episode. Feel free to share your thoughts and experiences at the comment section below.
Okay, so if you want to get across to us, our social media pages are available. Send us a mail. Our email address is also available.
Yeah. If you have personal messages or you have topics you want us to treat, we would be happy to do that.
Bye!